Hi everyone, in this tutorial we are going to cover what is singleton design pattern and how many way we can create a singleton design pattern and what is the best practice to write our singleton design pattern. Okay, so first of all, the singleton design pattern is one creational design pattern as it deal with the object creation. And the use case when we need to use the singleton design pattern is something like if you have some common shareable data and you want to share it across multiple classes. So in that situation, by sharing it manually using static keyword, we should go for the singleton design pattern. Okay, so the best example of singleton I can say from our Java language, that is the java.lang.runtime. Okay, Java provides a runtime class that represents the current runtime environment in which an application is running. So since the runtime environment is unique, there should only be one instance of that runtime class. This is what Java internally following the singleton design pattern. Okay, so let's quickly create the singleton design pattern with all the approaches, and at the end we will conclude which one is the best practice and which we need to use. Okay, now let's see all the possible solution with code sample one by one. Okay, so let's, I created a project, so let's create a class called Igor Singleton. Okay, where in this Igor Singleton our instance will be initialized eagerly, as this is the simplest approach where the instance of the class will be created at the time of class loading. So let's see it by the code. Okay, so the first step of singleton, always we should declare our constructor as private. Okay, so let's declare it. Now let's create an instance of the class at the time of class loading. Okay, so that's why created something like private static final, then create the object of our class. Okay, let's name it instance so that it will be meaningful. Now let's provide a global point of access to the instance. Okay, so create a method, public static Igor Singleton get instance. Name the method, name is get instance. Let's follow the naming convention. Now return this instance which we created at the time of class loading. Okay. Okay, so now let's test this Igor Singleton, whether we are getting the same hash code or not by creating the multiple object. Okay, so this is just assume as a test class. Okay, so I created object 1, object 2, and I was going to print the hash code of both. Okay, so let's run a Java class. Yep, it's giving both hash code as same. Okay, so that means it follows the singleton behavior. Okay, but we should not recommend to use this approach, as the disadvantages of this approach is that the instance is created irrespective of whether it is accessed or not. Okay, so like this is fine if the object is simple and does not hold any system resource, but it can have performance issue. Okay, so that's why there is one more approach called lazy singleton. Okay, so let's create a class. Lazy singleton. Okay, so in this lazy singleton approach, the object will be initialized lazily. It means delaying the initialization of something until the first time it need. Okay, So that's why here we are going to add the null check. If object is not created, then create a new object. If it is already exist, then return the same which we already have. Okay, so the first step, create the constructor as private. Okay, and create a static reference of your lazy singleton class, private static instance. Okay, now create a static factory method. Inside that we'll add the null check. If object is not created, then it will create a new one. Okay, so create a static factory method, public static, and factory of our lazy singleton. Get instance. Here just add one null check. If instance equal to null means it's not created yet, then create a new object and return it. Okay, so instance equal to new lazy singleton. Okay, directly return from here. Else return the existing one. Okay, so we declare the constructor private so that other class can access directly. And as this is the static factory method, so we declare one static variable and there we add one null check. Okay, now let's test this lazy singleton approach. Okay, go to our app.java, change it to lazy singleton object. Okay, so here again created two object and printing the hash code of these two object. Run a Java application, we are getting the same hash code for both the object, object 1 and object 2. Okay, so it means it follow the behavior of singleton design pattern, right? But this application, this class won't work on multi-thread environment. Okay, so to avoid the race condition on multi-thread environment, we should use the synchronized keyword. Okay, so now if we use synchronized here, it will be avoid the race condition so that the multiple thread can enter one by one. Okay, let's say the instance is not created yet and two threads simultaneously enter into the get instance method, and in that case instance equal to null check will evaluate and it will return the true. Okay, so it means both the thread will create a new instance of the class, right? So to avoid this kind of situation, we used synchronized keyword. But first time instance equal to null, and when two thread coming simultaneously to this get instance method, both will evaluate and it will return the true, so that two object will be created by two thread. Okay, so it leads the performance issue. So to avoid this issue, there is one more approach to add the double check locking. Okay, so in the case of double check locking, first it will check for the object created or not, then second time it will come to the synchronized block, and again inside synchronized block it will check instance equal to null or not. Means two times it will checking like object is created or not. Okay, so let's check the double checking one. Let's create one more class, double checking lazy singleton. Okay, so let me copy paste this syntax and later we'll change it. Just change the class name as part of constructor. Okay, okay, now here we need to add the double check. So we should not keep the synchronized keyword on method level. Okay, if instance equal to null, then check the synchronized here with the class double checking lazy singleton dot class. Now here again we need to add if instance equal to null, then return this okay, else return the existing instance. Okay, so instead of return inside the block, let's return it end of the block. Okay, if object is not created, instance will be initialized here, or else it will point to the same instance which we declared, right? So let's check this one. Let's test this double checking lazy singleton. So let's go to the app.java class. Here let's change it to our double check singleton. Okay, now let's run this application. We are getting same hash code, right? So it means it is following the singleton design pattern behavior, and along with that it provides the efficient way for the double check to avoid the multi-threaded issue such that race condition, right? So the double checking is very important here. Let's understand the workflow, how it is working. Let's say that two thread T1 and T2 get entered to this get instance method simultaneously. The instance equal to null check will evaluate true, so both of them will enter to the synchronized block. Okay, and as we know, synchronized block execution should be one by one, so thread entered to the instance equal to null. So in T1 and T2 thread, the one thread entered to the this if condition check and he will get the instance. Same for the second object. So there is no chance to get the multiple instance of our singleton bean. Okay, now let's move to some different approach, that is lazily initialized inner class singleton. Okay, we'll initialize the singleton bean with the help of inner class. Okay, so this concept came up with the help of a person, Bill Park. So he came up with very efficient solution to create a singleton. It is called initialization on demand. Okay, and in this approach, a static inner class is used to lazily create a singleton bean. Okay, so let's create that one. Let me create one more class. Lazy inner class singleton. Okay, so here first declare the constructor as private lazy inner class singleton. Okay, now let's create a static inner class who will return the object of our lazy inner class singleton. Okay, so let me create a class private static class singleton helper, and it is returning the object of our lazy class singleton. Okay, now write one more method which other class can access globally. Okay, so public static object of our lazy inner class singleton get instance. Now return the object of lazy singleton, lazy inner class singleton, with the help of singleton helper. Okay, singleton helper dot instance. Okay, now let's test this lazy inner class singleton approach, whether it is following the singleton behavior or not. Okay, let's go to the app.java. So let's change the object syntax here. Okay, so we have lazy inner class singleton two object, object one and object two. Let's check the hash code of both. It should return the same. Okay, we are getting the same hash code in lazy inner class singleton approach. Okay, so in this approach you might note that the inner class is not loaded until the get instance method is invoked for the first time. Okay, so this solution is thread safe, even we don't need to add manually the synchronize. Okay, so I could say it is the most efficient approach among all the singleton design pattern implementation which we already done. So this one is the best practice. Always you need to use this singleton design pattern with the help of inner class. Okay, yep. This we just covered how to create a singleton class with all the efficient way. Okay, so in my next video I am going to cover what are the possible way to break the singleton rules and how we can prevent them. Okay, so yep, that's it about this particular video, guys. If anyone have any doubt or concern, you can add a comment, and those who not subscribed yet, please go ahead and subscribe it. And thanks for watching this video.